Hello everyone, welcome to Eye to Eye. We're live here at the Penn Valley Community College, MCC Penn Valley, right here in Kansas City, Missouri. We're live here because we told you on our last few shows, even into our last season, that we will be here on a more often and frequent basis. And now we're here on a more and often frequent basis here at Penn Valley. So, so you can expect some things that you can't expect. We will be doing on the point on student interviews about how things are here at Penn Valley and some of the student life, and of course different aspects of community college. Now there's a recent report that was released today that enrollment at community colleges has dropped, and this is due to new jobs coming out, that is due to the reason that the enrollment is low at community colleges. And some are even going to directly to the four-year route, the more expensive route that some would call it. And that is pretty much those particular two key reasons of why that's why low enrollment is happening at many different colleges, community colleges across the country, and of course here at Penn Valley, MCC Penn Valley. Now, due to the low enrollment and the amount of money that community colleges get, these particular colleges that we're live at today. They are making some cutbacks. They have to make some cutbacks in order to be in business. So just take a brief look at that. But let's take a look at what's going on our show today here on Eye to Eye, Kansas City. Well, first we're going to talk about a recent released video that was released yesterday. And I think it was about Mitt Romney making a comment of the 47% of Barack Obama's supporters. Now, in that video, he goes off the comment. Now, to note, this video was not released. This comment was not released. I mean, this particular video was not supposed to be released, but however it did, I'm not going to offer my commentary after you see the video, so here it is.
There are 47% of the people who will vote for the president no matter what. All right, there are 47% who are with him, who are dependent upon government, who believe that they are victims, who believe that government has a responsibility to care for them, who believe that they are entitled to health care, to food, to housing, to you name it. But that's an entitlement, and government should give it to them. And they will vote for this president no matter what. And I mean, the president starts off with 48, 49, 40, he starts off with a huge number. These are people who pay no income tax. 47% of Americans pay no income tax. So our message of low taxes doesn't connect. And he'll be out there talking about tax cuts for the rich. I mean, that's what they sell every 4 years. And so my job is not to worry about those people. I'll never convince them that they should take personal responsibility and care for their lives. What I have to do is convince the 5 to 10% in the center that are independent, that are thoughtful, that look at voting one way or the other, depending upon, in some cases, emotion, whether they like the guy or not.
Okay, everyone, welcome back to Eye to Eye, Kansas City. Now, what you saw there was the secret video that was given to us here at Eye to Eye, Kansas City. Now, like I said, Mitt Romney, he doesn't know how to connect with the people. All he is a businessman that is trying to make money. And with the one percenters, which is the mighty elite, or the rich folks, to be broken down terms for you, the rich are doing anything and everything that they can to make sure that lower to middle class people cannot get basic services that they need. And this, for example, students here at Penn Valley Community College, a good number of students here receive Pell Grants, receive financial aid of some type, scholarships and other forms of student financial aid. So, so with this being said, if you vote for someone that isn't for you guys are in the blame, you guys are a part of the blame game that they are playing with now in Washington. Now, going into the video, I think that his comments was distasteful, it was disrespectful, that he just claims that all 47% of Barack Obama's supporters were on welfare, because it's not true. I'm one of his supporters, and I'm not on any assistance. I might use financial aid. I'm on Pell Grant right now, and that's the kind of aid I'm using, and people like myself are using those things because they are available. They're there. They are of assistance, and if they're there and they are to help folks, so why not use that? So, like I said, the man's distasteful. He's disrespectful. He doesn't know how to relate to people, and I think that's the major problem that he's having. And now that he has bum rushed Obama and said all these little negative things, this comment could either hurt him or kill him in the elections. But I think people are looking at the debates that are coming up, and of course I will have my commentary on that when it does happen, so stay tuned to Eye to Eye Kansas City, and also log on to galvinbkc.weebly.com for the latest information. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to shift gears to Kansas City news, rather. And Kansas City right now, there's the new tax that was voted on August the 7th that was in, that was going towards the half-cent sales tax for parks and community centers. With that portion of that fund will help demolish vacant and deteriorated homes here in Kansas City, Missouri. And the main focus is in the urban core of these old homes. Now, I don't know what to think of that, but why not allocate money? And this is prior to this half-cent sales tax. Why not every year allocate some money to demolish a home or two in some of these neighborhoods? These homes that have not been in good repair, these homes that have not been in good shape, and have had crime going on in those particular areas that these homes have been sitting there and deteriorated from. So I just want people to know that that's where they're talking about getting that setting that money aside for that. But as well, they've also said here to Eye to Eye, sent a statement here to Eye to Eye, and I'm not going to read the statement. It's not really a statement, but it was some information here to Eye, Kansas City, and I'm going to share briefly with you some of that. Now, that particular half-cent sales tax that I just mentioned, it is going to go to the parks, to maintain the parks, the community centers around here in Kansas City, Missouri, and of course, we'll have a big impact to keeping these community centers open for more extended hours. Now, one particular community center that I'm going to say, I'm not sure you see a big difference, is the Brush Creek Community Center, because they're open from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. rather. And I think you should make those accessible, have programs for these for kids that are getting out of school and that need that extra curricular activity for free, low cost activities at most of these community centers. Now, there are some community centers across the city that will provide this services for free or at low cost. So maybe if the city was to do some looking into that. Now, last season we reported on an event that has caused terror in one Kansas City neighborhood on Kansas City's east side. And of course, that particular community center, again, is the Brush Creek Community Center. Now, this happened over the course of July and early part of August. And that has proven that there might, if we could work with this program, if we can get the kids that are acting crazy and after the event is over and running into oncoming traffic and so forth, I think if we was to handle those kinds of problems and we set a good time to where these kids and their parents, where the parents do come and pick up their kids, I think the program can work. But it takes a lot of tweaking and it takes a lot of the parents to do their share. So I don't know if we're going to do that. But let's take a look at your headlines from the Associated Press. We'll be right back here on Eye to Eye, Kansas City.
This is AP News Minute. President Obama and Mitt Romney set aside their differences for an evening to tell jokes at a charity dinner in New York. Both return to campaigning in battleground states Friday. U.S. officials say the CIA linked the Benghazi, Libya attack to militants within 24 hours. The CIA station chief in Libya reported that a heavily armed group attacked the U.S. consulate last month. Survivors of the Fort Hood attack and victims' relatives want the government to declare it a terrorist attack. The declaration would allow survivors and relatives to collect combat benefits. And a wildfire destroyed more than half the homes in a tiny North Dakota town. About 30 people live in the town of Bucyrus. Matt Small, The Associated Press, with AP News Minute.
That are watching this program, are you registered to vote? Now, we have resources available right on my website, which is galvinbkc.weebly.com. And on the website, just click on Voter Registration Resources 2012, and that will navigate you to all the resources to get you registered to vote. And I'm speaking to those who are not registered to vote. And those who are registered to vote, just take a look at some of the information that could help you get others to be registered to vote. We want everyone to be registered to vote. We want everyone to register to vote this November, because this is a big election that could decide everything or nothing. So, and of course, you can keep it right here on Eye to Eye, Kansas City this November, because we'll have all the results, and the breakdown in the political reports coming from our partners from the Associated Press. So keep it all right here on Eye to Eye, Kansas City. Now, we're going to go ahead and take a break, and we will be right back here on Eye to Eye, talk a little bit about more stories.
Oh, here's one.
This movie is...
They get married at the end.
Yeah. Wait, next. What about this?
Turns out he's an alien. The whole thing's one big dream.
Yeah.
Wait. How about the one where a group of friends encounter something totally unexpected? Very spicy.
How's it end?
With you driving us to Wendy's.
Wendy's Asiago Ranch Chicken Club is totally unexpected. Our boldly spicy whole filet, applewood smoked bacon, and natural Asiago cheese. Way past ordinary. That's Wendy's way.
Now that's better.
And now get a Frosty for just 99 cents.
And I'm feeling good. Fish in the sea, you know how I feel. River running free, you know how I feel. Blossom on the tree, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good.
welcome back everyone here in Kansas City. Now, we just talked about the upcoming elections in November. Now, seasonal hiring is taking place right now, rather. I hope this thing is working. My script here on my phone is sometimes iffy. Now, like I said, seasonal hiring is occurring right now for the Christmas season and, of course, Thanksgiving as well, which will give employees a jump start to earn money. And, of course, for seasonal positions, this could be a way to see if you like this company and another way to get employed full-time if you enjoy working at the places that you would like to, that you're applying to, and so forth. Now, we're going to put together a special page for you guys. We're going to put together a special page on GalvinBKC.weebly.com, and that's going to help you get hired. That's going to help you write better resumes and everything that you need to know about getting jobs. Now, we talked about the last time the different types of unemployment and why those different types of unemployment are what's going on in the current economy. Now, I want to also talk about economics as politics, politics as economics. Whatever is going, like I said about the one percenters earlier, 1%, the one percenters are always getting the kickbacks in Washington. And why is that? Because there is a comfy, cozy relationship going on. And that comfy, cozy relationship is in terms of less regulations, more tax breaks for businesses, big businesses rather, and no relaxations for the 99%. And the 99% is you guys that are watching this program, you guys, the middle class to lower class folks that are watching this program and is wondering, how can I make it out of this economy? How can I make it in this economy? How can I afford to pay my bills with a little check that I get every week, every 2 weeks rather? And that's a question that I've often wondered myself. How can I make it in this economy doing a small production like this and have a little money for myself? That's the question I have for myself sometimes. But the answer to that question is, You have to keep on making it. And you have to, and the major thing I'd like to tell folks is, do the necessities in this economy. Don't get behind in your car payment if the car is taking you to go make the money. Don't get behind in your house payments. Do the best that you can do with what you got. And that's something that Dave Ramsey, told us here at when I met him a long way back. Dave Ramsey told me a few key issues on that when I met him way back. So I want people to understand that we all are going through this as people, and I feel your pain. I really do. I'm not no means of a part of the one percenters. I'm not even close to the 1%. I do attend college here at Penn Valley Community College, so I can relate to you guys in a level that is different, but yet I can see your struggles. I can understand your struggles. So do keep that in mind when I am here, right here at Penn Valley Community College. Welcome back, everyone. All right. I have to share this with you, ladies and gentlemen. Now, September 11th, we didn't air a show because we wanted to give people the room to remember what happened September 11th, 2001. In 2001, the Twin Towers in New York, the World Trade Center, collapsed. And I know that image is not going to go away by all means. It's not going to go away. And I don't want that to. We can't forget what has took place from then to now. But I don't like sometimes the media popping this up every September 11th. And the reason why that is because families are still going through hard times, trying to get through their loved ones being lost in that tragedy. And that tragedy is a serious one that we can't forget, that we can't brush off our minds. But I don't want it to be a thing in the media to where we just play it every September 11th, every single time. Without no thought of the people, the families that are affected by September 11th from the World Trade Center and the Pentagon attacks in Washington, D.C. So I can't say this much. Families that were affected by September 11th, 2001, the folks here at Eye to Eye have you in our prayers at this time. And with this said, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to end our show today. I thank you for watching our program, and you can log on for all of the show's details and everything on EYETOEYEKC.wmv.